A new report this morning, the Wall Street Journal says the president's personal attorney went to great lengths to keep a former porn star from speaking out about an alleged affair she had with Trump before he was president. This is back in 2006.
All right, joining us now, one of the authors of this story, Michael Rothfeld, investigative reporter for the Wall Street Journal. Thanks so much for being with us. As we said, in another era, you know, you would be, you know, the most sought after reporter in America right now to explain this story. This is that Donald Trump's personal attorney, Michael Cohen, and we've all seen him on TV, many of us have spoken to him extensively, set up a private company to pay off this adult film star. Explain.
He set up a company called Essential Consultants, LLC, in Delaware, and it basically distances him from the payment. And people commonly will use shell companies, corporations, in order to do like a one-off transaction. And that way, his name isn't, you know, on a transfer to another bank, so many people would not see where the money was coming
unless
from.
Unless they're investigative reporters like you, and he wasn't as careful as he could have been to shield his name from being attached to this. Timing matters. This alleged payoff happened weeks before the election, October.
That's right, about 3 weeks before. And we know that Stormy Daniels, whose real name is Stephanie Clifford, a former porn star, had been in discussions with Mr. Cohen for several weeks, months actually, to about trying to reach a non-disclosure agreement. Mm.
What exactly, and I want to be careful about this, is Michael Cohen now denying, and what is he not denying about this story right now?
He has denied that any sexual encounter took place between the president and Stormy Daniels. He has not denied to us that there was any payment or settlement agreement. He just hasn't addressed questions about that at all.
It's also interesting, if you look at her statement, Stormy Daniels denies any hush money payoff. We have it here. Rumors that I have received hush money from Donald Trump are completely false. If indeed I did have a relationship with Donald Trump, trust me, you wouldn't be reading about it in the news. She goes on to say you'd read about it in the book. But she says specifically there are no hush money from Donald Trump, not no hush money from his lawyer or this
exactly.
account.
We think that was a carefully worded statement saying I didn't get anything from Trump himself.
All right. Say all of this happened. Say Essential Consultants LLC paid Stormy Daniels $130,000 to keep quiet. Anything inherently or necessarily illegal about that? What are the questions?
Well, first of all, I'm not a lawyer, so, you know, I can't give legal exactly commentary. But people reach non-disclosure agreements all the time, so that in itself is not a problem. I think the question that people have raised are, A, you know, are there any tax issues? Were taxes paid or, you know, reported? Potentially there could be campaign finance issues if it's considered an in-kind campaign contribution, depending on who paid the money and exactly how it was structured. These are questions we don't know, right?
We don't know where this money was from.
We don't know. We believe that Michael Cohen made the payment, but whether he received money from someone else or was later reimbursed, those are questions that we're still looking for the answers to.
Any law enforcement agencies, as far as you can tell, asking those same questions?
We don't have any information on that at this point.
Okay.
Michael Rothfeld, fascinating. Thanks so much for being with us. Appreciate it.